Today is 19th June, English video session for class 10. I continue from the topic of the Nelson Mandela Long Walk to Freedom Part 1, the speech of Nelson Mandela. Now, a few moments later, we all lifted our eyes and aimed at a spectacular array of South African jets. Usually, you have seen the way the inauguration takes place. The jets will be going up in a V-shape, make some formation, L-shape, V-shape, okay, like that, and they move and they send flags, they send colors, rainbow colors, etc. That's jets, helicopters and troops carriers rolled in perfect formation over the Union buildings. It was not only a display of pinpoint precision and military force, but a demonstration of military loyalty to democracy. You want to show that the military is showing its loyalty, its bondage to the democracy, to the new government that had been freely and fairly elected. This is called the democratic election. Only moments before, the highest generals of South African defense force and police, their chests bedecked with ribbons and medals from days by celebrated and pledged their loyalty. Okay, so before the president, all the people in the higher officials, they take their pledge and assume their duty. I was not unmindful of the chapter of M5 jets left a smoke trail. Of the fact that not so many years before, they would not have saluted but arrested. Just few years back, the same people would have arrested me and put me in a prison. But today, the same people have bowed down, they are taking pledge and respecting us. Okay. Finally, a charcoal of Imphala jets left a smoke trail of black, red, green, blue and gold of the new South African flag. Okay. So it shows that the freedom is born. The day was symbolized by the playing of our two national anthems, a vision of white city, singing a song, and black city, another dyson, an old open anthem of Republic. Although that day native groups knew the lyrics of the anthem they once despised, they would soon know the words by heart. The first day nobody can learn. Today, if you are asked to sing the national anthem, you just close your eyes and sing, because you are being singing in your way right from your birth. It's not a difficult task. But on that day only, they have started to sing. They were finding it difficult. On the day of inauguration, I was aware that for the sons of history, in the first decade of the 20th century, a few years after the bitter Anglo-Boer War, and before my own birth, the white-skinned people of South Africa patched up their differences and erected a system of racial domination against the dark-skinned people of their own land. Both of them belong to the same land, but the whites felt they are more superior than the blacks. Of course, okay. Yeah, the structure they created formed the basis of the harshest. Look at the terms used. Harshest. Beyond this, there is nothing. That much harsh. Most inhuman. If there is nothing to do with humanity at all, most inhuman society the world has ever known. Now, it is the last decade of the 20th century and my own 8th decade as a man. He himself is in 80s, 8th decade as a man. The system has been overturned forever and replaced by one that recognizes the rights and freedom of all people, not to one section of the people, but to all people, regardless of the color of your skin. It is so very inhuman to consider and give privilege to people based on the color of your skin. That day had come through the unimaginable sacrifices. Thousands of my people. This is the long walk. Remember, long walk. representative of all those people who had died there. That long and noble night ended, and now began again to me. I was pained. It was so sorrowful for me that I was not able to thank them, and that they were not able to see what their sacrifices had brought. You know, what the word brought has brought into their sacrifices has brought into its own way of expressing it. The policy of Bharati, the entire thing is based on the policy of Bharati. Segregating people is for their race and color. Greater deep the lasting mood in my country and my people. All of us will spend many years, if not generations, recording from the performer. It's not that yesterday it is over and today we have come to liberty and we forgot that it will take ages for us to forget how much of inhuman things are done to me, the sufferings which we have endured. It will take ages for us to forget all those things. Recovery from the performer, but decades of oppression and brutality has another unuttered and intended effect, and that was it produced the Ayur Tambos, Vajra Sisters, Chief Uthilis, the use of Dadus, Brown Fishing, Robert Sobukwes, and our Tambos are all the most important members belonging to the African National Congress. Okay, men of such extraordinary courage, not ordinary courage, the courage which made them never to lose, whether never to show fear and to always keep up their mind against the Ahari. Wisdom and generosity that they like, that their life may never be known and doomed. Perhaps it requires such a depth of cooperation to break such heights of character. So only when they are pushed so much can such heights of character be brought. My country, please look into this sense. My country is rich in minerals and gems. Africa makes resources, rich in resources, gems and lightning and so on. But look what they say. I have always known that the greatest of its wealth is its people. It's the people who are more powerful, more, what to say, rich, finer and truer than the purest diamonds. This is why Nelson R. Mandela. Take it. Shall we go? I continue. It is from these comrades in the struggle that I learned the meaning of courage. Time and again, I have seen men and women risk and give their lives for an idea. I have seen men stand up to attacks and torture without breaking. Breaking is without losing their heart and mind. They don't surrender. Showing the strength and resilience that defies the imagination. I learned that courage was not the absence of fear, but the triumph of it. It's a new definition for courage. If you have an absence of fear, we usually think that if you don't have fear, then you've got courage. No. It's the one who rules over the fear is called courageous. The brave man is not he who does not feel afraid, but he who conquers the fear. No one is born hating any other person because of the color, of the skin, background, religion. People must learn to hate. This is a very contradictory sentence, but look at the truth behind it. People must learn to hate, and if they can learn to hate, they can be taught to love. So now comes the naturally to the human. So it is so natural. You don't need to become different or artificial in order to become bad. Okay, you are naturally, the human heart gives us love. Even in the grimmest times in prison, when my comrades and I were pushed to our limits, I would see a glimmer of humanity in one of the boxes. So it's not that always somebody will be there to give us at least a sort of a smile or hold us when we fall. Those things are considered perhaps for a second and that will play enough to reassure me and keep me going. Even that sort of, that is the power of love and humanity. Man's goodness is a flame that can be heated, never be extinguished. Extinguished, which can be blown out. In life, every man has three obligations. Obligation, you need to do all these duties, obliged obligations. What are the two obligations everybody has got? Obligation to the family, you have a duty as your family has got to his parents, his wife, his children. Again, you have another obligation. What is that? You have obligation to the people, the community, this country, to the people. You have to serve the people. In a civil and humane society, each man is able to fulfill these obligations according to his own inclinations and abilities. So as for his labor, each one is doing their work. But in a country like South Africa, it was almost impossible for a man of my birth and color to fulfill both these obligations because of the apartheid, policy of apartheid. South Africa, the men were not able to do these two obligations. In South Africa, man of color who attempted to live a human being was punished and assimilated. In South Africa, a man who tried to fulfill his duty to his people was inevitably ripped from his family, taken away totally from his family and his home, and forced to live in a life apart, a twin out existence of secrecy and rebellion. Okay? Next. I did not in the beginning choose to place my people above the family. Always, it is the family first. Now, but in attempting to serve my people, I found that I was preventing to fulfill my obligation as a son, a brother, a father, and a husband. I was not born with hunger to be free. I was born free, free in every way that I could know. Free to run in the field, near my mother's house, free to swim from the stream that ran through my village, free to roam the meadows under the stars, and ride a bow drawn by physical neighbors. The usual happiness a small kid would have. As long as I obeyed my father and I abided by the customs of my tribe, I was untroubled by the laws of man or not. It was only when I began to learn that my boyhood freedom was an illusion, when I discovered as a man that my freedom had already been taken away from me, that I began to hunger for. So when as he started growing as a young man, he thought, he believed that his power, his real entitlement, his real happiness had been taken away, totally ripped off from him. At first, as a student, I wanted freedom only for myself. Usually, the children, they were not beyond it. The transitory freedom of being able to stay out of night, be what I please, go where I choose. Later, as an end man, in Japan as well, I learned from the basic of having the freedom of achieving my potential of earning my keep, marrying, having a family, freedom not to be obstructed in a lawful life. I need a life which is very happy and which is lawfully fine everywhere. I am protected also. But there is a piece of that not only was I not free, but my brothers and sisters were not free. I am not free, brothers are not free, my sisters are not free. That we are all in entitled. Yes. I saw that it was not just my freedom that was given, but the freedom of everyone who looked like I did. That is when I joined the African National Congress, and that is when the hunger for my own freedom became the greatest hunger for freedom of my people. The hunger of many people for freedom together is the African National Congress. Yes, it was this desire for the freedom of my people to the lives, to live their lives with dignity. What is their fight only for? To live their own life with dignity, with respect, self-respect. Of my people, it was this desire for freedom of my people and their lives with dignity and self-respect that animated my life, that transformed that frightened their man into a bold one. That drew a law-abiding attorney to become a criminal, that turned a family-loving husband into a man without a home, that forced a life-loving man like living in a home. I'm no more if you